Howdy everyone, Poacher here with an Age of Magic video. In today's video, we're jumping into Sands of Doom level 6. The idea is we're trying to use teams to get the best scores and comprising all the information and putting it on my website. The link is in the description below. So these are endgame teams, but hopefully at one point I hope to go through and do teams that you can use on auto, so you can just get through this as fast as possible. But remember, Cradle of Chaos is endgame content into like level 2 and level 3 or region 2 and 3. So at the moment, we'll put all missions in one video, but as we get into the later regions, we will start to split it up as the missions become harder and harder and longer and longer. So we'll jump into level 6. This is a fairly easy level, but there are some nodes that do require a bit of RNG. So going into the first node, we have a one waiver, and we are going to use a bomb team. So we're going to go Beastman and get the Valar, because bomb does extra damage, AoE, and we are going to go, we want Undead, we want Blood Mage, we want Dark Elves, we want Azariel, and the idea is to get this in one turn. Then we're going to go the final character, the Kobolds, Soothsayer. And you're probably wondering why all these characters. Let's jump into battle and I will explain it. So Valar leading because he allows AoE damage to do more damage. It doesn't crit though. And with the Blood Emperor and the Azariel on the team, what you will notice is both of these characters apply a debuff to the enemy without even having to cast an ability. So that's going to increase the damage of the bomb. So we're going to jump this down to a regular speed and we will do the bomb and hopefully get it in one turn, and there you go. That's how you get a nice easy 1 point kill on mission number one. So fairly straightforward. Obviously the stronger your soothsayer, the easier the mission is going to be. We will now move into mission number two. Moving into mission number two, now you have two options. Number one, you can use a Teona, which will get you a 2 point victory, or if you have him, Thainarg, who can complete the mission in one turn. So we're going to jump into the mission now. We're going to easily just go ahead and use our AoE ability, his second, and wipe the enemy out and get a nice 1 point victory. Real simple. Only RNG that's going to bend you over is if any dodges happen or anything like that. But 1 point, and that is mission two. With Teona, it can be done in two turns if you do not have Thainarg. We'll move into mission three now. Mission three is where some RNG is going to take place. It is a two wave node. We're going to go high elves with Orahaim, the Kabuto, and the Daimyo, and a librarian. So librarian is going to wipe the first wave, and we're hoping for the double proc on the second wave from the Orahaim. So we'll jump into the mission. Here we go. Wonderful AoE. Bang, wipe out the first, and we will come through and hopefully get the double proc right off the bat. We do get it. One turn. Oh, that rarely ever happens for me. Orahaim has cursed my account. I hate using her, but that is how the mission is complete. You'll have to do it a few times. The idea with the Kabuto and the Daimyo is they're so slow that they're not going before Orahaim. So having them on the team is going to increase the chances by 8.8%, I think it is, per character or high elf to get that double proc from the Orahaim. So that's why you put them in the team. But we'll move on to mission number four now. Moving into mission number four, and we are going to go an Arcane Leader. Now, the idea of Arcane is that she increases damage of allies, orcs, by 30%. But if they're not orcs, the damage is increased by 15%. So it's still a decent damage increase. I think it's 15%. It could be 10, 20, or 15, 30. One of the other. She's going to increase the damage of your allies. Then we're going Teodor, and then we're going the Wombo combo of characters. We're going to go the Pride, the Stealthy, and a Sooner on top. Now, there is a bit of RNG to this, but the idea is that Teodor gives himself a 6-stack guaranteed crit. So when he uses his AoE, he's going to crit all enemies. Now, Stealthy is going to support attack each one of those enemies, and Sooner has a 50% chance for non-Beastman allies to support attack enemies that are crit. So let's explore. Right, so Teodor is going to go do his AoE, which is a guaranteed crit, and then Stealthy will come through with support attacks. But because all of these hits are crits, there is the chance that Suna, a 50% chance, will also support attack. So she has the potential to clean up any characters left behind. But that's the RNG factor of it. May not work every time. You may have to do it a few times. But it can be done when Suna does get that 50% chance. As you can see, she got one support attack in there and cleaned up a character that we weren't going to kill originally. So that brings us to a 399 point victory. Moving us on to the final node, which is probably going to have the worst RNG of it all. Moving into the final mission, mission 5, and there is a fair amount of RNG to this fight. So prepare for potentially a bit of a sit down until you get it. This is the team we're using, Rhiannon, Dravorad, Mirrodin. These three work really well together, but we are looking at Rhiannon's leadership ability. It gives a 12% per druid, so 36% all up, for a support attack to happen from an ally, which is what we're counting on. We're hoping for a support attack from the Morrigan on the second wave, and then the flame AoE. Yeah, so we'll explain it. We'll jump into the fight. Now, first RNG comes in the first battle. We're going to use Morrigan's basic flaming blade, I think it was called. We do not get the kill. So now we're going to stop the video until we do get the kill, and we'll explain everything along the way, but we're going to run it in 4x speed because this is going to take me a while. Jumping into battle, we're using Morrigan's basic attack. We get the support. That's the first RNG. So there's two parts of RNG in that first stage. Using Morrigan's basic attack and getting the kill on 4 of the 5 targets, sometimes that Hargrim is going to live. So that's the first step. The second step is getting the RNG for the support attack on the Siegfried and killing him. So there we go. The second part of this is now using Flames AoE and then getting the support attack from the Morrigan. So we're going to use our AoE from Flame and then support. Beautiful. Okay. There we go. This took me a few attempts. I'm probably about attempt 20 before I got this. Your Morrigan, I want to say, has to be pretty close to max to be able to get 2 points in this. It would be a struggle if she wasn't. But there you go. There is a 2-turn kill on the final mission, bringing us a point of 3993. I think that is the best we can get in level 6, but there you go. That is the guide for level 6 and how to get the best score possible.